Okay. So now all we have is like half of Depths and then we're on to Blight Town. Brings my own. Okay. Look at how shit this damage is. Actually, against these guys, it's not really that bad. I mean, it's still pretty bad, but. Why did you kick? Of course, you jump back, and you're dead. Two of them dropped humanity, okay. Honestly, it just feels a lot better for me, like, not playing hitless. It's like, routing is really fun, and then actually, like, doing the run is pretty annoying. Because you can just get memed on by so many things. Like, that gargoyles thing, like, getting hit to gargoyles just then shouldn't have happened at all. I don't know what I just picked up. Was it shield or was it sword? I can check. Definitely shield. Wow, what a miss. What a spectacular whiff. Ring of the Evil Eye. I used to think that was like the best ring in the game. Ah, man. Those were the days. I love how I'm reminiscing about something that was literally like 3 months ago. Actually, how long have I had Dark Souls? I have no idea. I feel like it's more than 3 months. Probably closer to six. Either way. I just like don't really have the, I guess the temperament you would call it for hitless. Cause it just like gets on my nerves really quick. And we're letting Lautrec kill Anastasia this time. So if Lautrec isn't dead, if Solaire was alive, his summon's end right there. Wait, did I kill Lautrec? Oh, I guess I didn't talk to Lautrec, so if you talk to Lautrec, his summon sign would be right there. What are other rings I can use? I don't know. I'm not actually gonna, like, use that, but. This gets decent damage, but it in New Game Plus 6, it's like, holy shit, we're doing nothing. There we go. I think that's like the warrior starting set. Oh, he moved his leg. Of course, you stupid motherfucker. Okay. Of course. I would miss. Oh, and I would get hit by whatever that goddamn hitbox was. I just hate this goddamn fight. It's so annoying. Like, literally, all of that damage was because he staggered me. I don't think he hit me once. So actually, yeah, at the end of this, I'm gonna set up for the all enemies killed hitless. I'm actually gonna do that one, cause I want something more like that to be my first run. Cause it's like there isn't setup, you just go through killing everything. It's like a casual playthrough for me. There you go. Just helped you off the ledge. That damage for the fucking riposte is crazy. Oh, that guy didn't. I was trying to aggro that guy by moving to the side a little bit, but. But magic, like I plan on using in that, will just destroy this. The magic in general in this game is just broken. Do they die from a backstab? Almost. Literally like 3 health away. It's depressing. Oh, he dropped something. Hey, get back here. What the fuck did I just say? Let's go. What arrows do I use? Okay, I use the large arrows. Should probably use feathered arrows in the all enemies killed. Just for a little bit more range with the longbow. Right here could be slightly annoying. Like, not like here specifically, but like, I'm gonna try something. If I run across, no. This dog just aggroes anyway. I would have to have like full stealth on. Okay, dick. This is why I hate dogs in this game. Yeah, I never grabbed the purple moss clumps, or the blooming purple moss clumps. Dog, why are you down here? You fell off. God, running across that backwards is like, why? It's not fun. Where is he? Right there. Isn't he? No, where the fuck is he? Oh, does he just like completely unloaded until I get there? Kind of funny. Yeah, so these dogs. I feel like with full stealth gear, those dogs won't notice me, so I can take care of them with a bow or magic pretty easily. I might need to take stealth gear off for that guy, so he'll aggro and not do that. Because usually he starts to either come down the ladder or he like tries to start coming down the ladder. I mean, at least this is still pretty strong, for where I am. Yeah, I feel like with RTSR, or even like without RTSR, as long as I have Dust Crown on and a good catalyst, these guys will just get one shot. That go over or under? They lose interest. Funny. No, don't turn around, you're making me miss more. So those two are from one of the ponds, or from one of the spawn points down where the mosquitoes are. They just like all the mosquitoes, after their spawn point, they come up to a certain point. But they go to a certain point and they just wait there. Which is why it seems like there's more than 21 mosquitoes. But there aren't, so it's fine. I actually want to get quite a bit of this done today. Like quite a bit of this New Game Plus. Let me check something real quick. Okay. So most of the time, Slumbering Dragon Crest Ring doesn't even seem necessary. And I'm including, NPC invaders and NPCs in the all enemies kill things. So like I have to let Lautrec kill Anastasia, Then I have to invade him in Orlando and kill him. So, I mean, with magic, that's not bad, but I do have to kill his lackeys as well. That's gonna be the annoying part, because otherwise I could just, walk up behind him with full stealth rings and then, put on RTSR and bellowing and just one-shot them with Darkbeard. I still might be able to do that, but I'll need to be quick and I'll need to practice it. Yeah, but having Ring of Fog right off the bat will be a huge help. Like with these guys, usually they're just like swarming up to me, but not today. Oh my god, that just barely doesn't one shot. Really? That hit me? Okay. Let's go, bud. Get down here. Okay, can I fucking hit him? My god. Oh, let's get rusted iron. I'll have to figure out what rings I'll need. I'm definitely gonna use bow for these guys. Just because it's so much more convenient to just snipe them. There should be one more. I'm probably gonna use a bow for these guys, like Hawkring and a longbow will probably kill them. Like from this distance, even without Hawkring, it'll probably kill. See? So these guys aren't a huge deal. Large? Yeah, large shard. Honestly, a lot of the game isn't gonna be a big deal, as long as I have like the gear that I have now. Like, I don't expect that to be like super hard. Cause especially if I run full stealth rings, these guys die really easily. Green shards. What a miss. Miss for the ages. Okay, this next pool of mosquitoes should only have five. Should. If it does, if it has more than five, then I was wrong about the mosquitoes. But like the two up there, the two all the way up there might be independent from these, but I'm not sure. Three, four, five. Well, I was wrong. There are two mosquitoes independent. Six, seven. Yeah, now they're gone. They're dead. That's it. And Mildred's really easy. You can just stun lock her. With a really fast weapon, you can just stun lock her, and she's pretty weak to magic, so. Why wouldn't it let me use the humanity there? That's weird. No, there's sound today, Last God. I'm just like not talking because there's not much to say right now. Oh, hey, I know why Kylana's not here. I was wondering why Kylana wasn't there for a second. I have to get. You don't hear any game sounds? Yeah, just because they're really low. Sorry. And also my headphone volume is really low, so there, that should be a bit better. Where is the pyro hand? There we go. Okay. So now Quelana should be there. Yeah, okay. Also, okay, what was that dialogue? I. Wow. Great talk, Quelana. I write back to you.
The voice of reason fails. Farewell.
You just talk while you're getting your ass kicked. What's wrong with you? Also, for the all enemies killed, I feel like I should let Siegmeier die by his daughter and then kill his daughter after. I don't know what else rings to put on. None of these rings like do anything for me right now. Reasonable for the Sigmire thing, because I'm thinking about like routing new game plus six all enemies killed hitless. So, oh god, that's loud. So, I don't know if I should kill Siegmire myself and just not let Sieglind come into existence at all, or if I should let Sieglind kill Siegmire and then kill Sieglind afterward. Because I want everyone to come into existence so that I can kill literally everyone that can exist. Aw, you dodged. Come on, Quelaag. Okay, good, that hit. I was about to get mildly annoyed. I mean, not even, because it's just Quelaag. Did she just start with the second hit of her combo? If you attempted a hit, let's just push him off the legend sends. Otherwise, if Sieglind exists, then let her do the work. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, because I don't know if I should make like everyone exist. Some people only exist if you follow quest lines. Because those are my two options, either let Sieglind kill him or just kick him off a cliff. I mean, neither are good options for Sigurd, but I feel like that's like the only dilemma I actually have with that run. Because there's also the thing, if you use Artorias' soul before you kill Manus, Sirion, the Lord's Blade, does not show up at Artorias' grave. So that's another thing that you can do if you want. I'm gonna make her exist though and kill her, so I'm just gonna do the same thing for Quelaana. Or not Quelaana, Sieglind. So I'm gonna follow all the quest lines to make everyone exist and then just kill everyone. Oh, and I have to get egg-headed. She only shows up after Manus. You thought you showed up earlier. It might be before Manus, but I've only ever gone back there after Manus. And sometimes I've like gone back into that arena right after I killed Artorias, and she wasn't there, and neither was the grave. I know she only shows up as long as you haven't used a soul yet. I'm fairly certain, because that's the only reason she's there. You think it's after a warp? Probably. Egghead me. Hey, I said egghead me. Dick. What? Can you not egghead me? That's the grab attack. There we go. Maybe I was too close to him. Either way, she's gonna die. Chester's gonna die. I don't know how I'm gonna kill Chester safely. He's probably the most dangerous for a hitless out of all the NPCs. I really don't know for Chester. I might just have to go like RTSR bellowing, etc., and just do like Crystal Soul Spear or Dark Beat as well as Pursuers. That's probably the way to go. I feel like the solution for most things in that run is just gonna be Dark Beat. It's kind of funny, and also kind of just broken, considering how many casts I'm gonna have. Because if I'm calling it New Game Plus 6, I can have up to 6 casts of Dark Beat. which is way too many. It's a good solution. Yeah, Dark Beat is like broken, so why not just abuse it if I'm gonna have six casts of it? It's like Chaos Bed Vestiges in 3. I've never used that, but I know it's like a crazy pyromancy. I know it's crazy. I don't think I've even gotten it in 3. I don't know where to get it, or how to get it. Because I'm pretty sure I found all the tomes and like bought all the stuff from people, but that's like as far as I could get. Old demon. Oh, okay. Okay. Kind of makes sense. I think I've only made like his hammer. Actually, I might have it then. I just like haven't used any pyromancies in that game, so. There's the pet itch. 4, 5, 6. Oh look, he's gone. Where did Ceaseless go? I guess it's some mystery. Okay, now I have to wait for my guy to go egghead. Oh. Wow, I'm stupid. I forgot to take the hit manager off the screen. Okay, hang on. I'm gonna bottomless box stuff. I literally feel like, either Crystal Soul Sphere or, Dark Beat is gonna be the solution for, like, half of my problems in, what I'm planning. Which is pretty stupid, but... I don't even know if I'm getting everything in the bottomless box. I'm just like going two down and pressing the button to put them in the box. Okay, am I egg-headed yet? I'm not? Okay. I don't know how I'm not egg-headed yet. I swear it's been long enough. In the box you go, where it stops ain't nobody knows. Yeah. Oh, did you know there's a limit to the bottomless box? I hit it once and then I just started selling everything after. Yeah, it's like 8,000 or something items. It's not truly bottomless. I think it was like my new game plus 9 playthrough. Yes, your joke is ruined. I am the ruiner of jokes. Yeah, but no, after like 8 or 9 playthroughs, of collecting everything and selling nothing to Frampt, and just throwing everything in the bottomless box, it filled up. So that was fun. I was like genuinely surprised as well. Also, I need to like finish upgrading all of the, like every set to at least plus 3. Because then I'll know like which sets to sell to Frampt, which items to sell to Frampt, and which ones not to. That's part of the reason why I'm like off camera gonna upgrade everything to plus 5, like all the weapons to plus 5, and then all of the armor to plus 3. Not egg vermifuge. Give me your useless spells. I'm thinking now. I don't know what I'm gonna need for the thing. I know Pyro Hand. I don't think I'm gonna use Miracles. There's not really much of a point to using Miracles, I feel like. Especially because Sorcery is just broken. So yeah, probably just Pyro Hand and like Manus Catalyst or Chain Crystallization Catalyst. And then like a really good riposte weapon for Gwyn, at least. Yeah, I have no idea what else. I don't know what else I want to use. Maybe Quelaag's Fury Sword for some places. Yeah, I really don't know. Like whenever I finish this stream, I'm gonna have to like look through my bottomless box and just figure out what I want. 'Cause that's gonna take a while. Actually, has anyone done an all enemies killed playthrough or hitless run? 'Cause I heard that someone had, but they had their VOD as sub only, so you couldn't watch it. So I don't really know if I should believe if they did it or not. God damn it. I fell off the thing. 'Cause like if they have it as sub only, I'm sort of inclined to believe they didn't actually do it. Know. I don't see anything on the Team Hitless site, so I'm just gonna assume no one's done it. I feel like the main problem is going to be the Dragon Bots and Izalith. Because those guys are pretty tanky. And I don't know if like one or two Dark Beads will be enough. Especially because I can't use Red Tearstone Ring in the lava. Like, I think I'll be getting a 40% buff just from the Crown of Dusk and the Bellowing Dragon Crest, but other than that, I don't know if two Dark Beads is enough with Manus Catalyst. See, this is all stuff I'm just gonna be figuring out in my run as I route it. Like, I'm gonna be like improvising how to kill everything. Actually, if I start with Pursuers and do one Dark Bead, it might be enough, depending on the damage Pursuers does, because I don't know how much damage Pursuers does. And I'd use stealth rings and probably spells for these guys. Oh, God damn it, he ran away. I feel like 90% of that, of all enemies killed is gonna, it's just gonna be magic. Magic or pyromancies, which I don't really like, but okay. How much, or rather, which Firekeeper souls do I have? Those three. It's an extra one. I can just use that. Okay, sure. Okay, what the hell? How is it not blocking the dog? I don't understand this. It's confusing and concerning, and I don't like it. Lock onto the dog, please. Okay, whenever I'm not locked onto the dog, bad things happen, so. Dogs suck. Yes, they really do. I don't know how I'm gonna deal with those little ones. After killing all of those guys, I might just stand up here, snipe these two dogs, and then just come up here and snipe these dogs with RTSR and Hawkring. Because with RTS, actually, just with RTSR would be enough. No Dark Souls canine enemy has ever been a good experience. Yeah. They are the worst. Like, just dogs and Dark Souls. It doesn't mix. It just doesn't mix well. I mean, at least they're not, like, literally everywhere like they are in 3. Because there are dogs in way too many places in 3. Bone dog is the worst. Oh yes, again, Darkbeed is the solution. Like, fuck those dogs, they're the worst. I am truly and honestly hoping Darkbeed is enough to kill them, like one Darkbeed. Oh, and then I'm just gonna run past these guys, I don't care. And then the room full of big skeletons, I'm just gonna use the Dragon King Great Axe. Just to R2 and kill them like that. Because if I use a bow to lure them all near the entrance, and then just R2 while I'm up near the top, they're not able to hit me and they're just gonna get destroyed by the R2, so. In theory, that should work. In practice, I don't actually know. Actually, I do know. I've done it with the Obsidian Greatsword before. So in practice, I do know. This guy would for sure be magic. Death to the dead dragon, yeah. I'm doing a surprising amount of damage to him. Also, I feel like the Bridge Drake should be like one of the first things I do. Oh, well shit, that surprised me. I feel like the Bridge Drake should be something I do like immediately. So I might just like clear out Upper Undead Burg like before I do anything else. Actually, I might just like go down, do Quelaag, bone back up to Firelink, and then clear out Upper Undead Burg, and then do Gargoyles from there after clearing out Undead Parish. It'll be a little bit longer, but that Bridge Drake is just like complete RNG, so I really don't want to take any chances later. I wrecked, noob. Imagine being so bad you get killed by a guy with this. It's literally a pole. Circle on the end. I feel like I was just like clipping his nails there. Like just clipping his nails until he just falls off. His nails were the only thing keeping him on. Pointy stick is greater than everything else. Yes. That is true. That is very true. After all, spear is really probably one of the first weapons humans made, so I don't know why I said humans like that, but you get my point.
Come back soon.
How many soul spears is that? Or soul arrows is that? 56. Let's go. I wish I could attune all 56 of those. That would be like the most stupid thing ever. Actually, imagine having like 99 attunement slots. With literally any spell. It's like 99 soul arrows. That's like way too many. Because you get 30 per slot. Actually, how many would that be? So 10 is 300, so 3,000, 2,970 soul arrows. Those are G. What do you mean GUI? Because you can have, I think, up to 12 attunement slots, because, like, look at this. And then, you can have. There are things that increase the amount of attunement slots you have. So, like, if this isn't, like, an indicator for 12 slots, I don't know what is. Yeah, it probably maxes at 12, but. I mean, there's no point. Or there's no real point in going more than 10. Because if you use, like, RTSR, Bellowing, and Duskcrown. Even if you replaced like Bellowing with something that would give you two more attunement slots, you would still probably get more damage from just having 10 attunement slots. Like, as strange as that sounds, because you'll just be getting like 20%, or actually, the stuff that has a lot of casts, more attunement slots would probably be worth it. I don't know, it's just like higher damage per hit versus higher damage overall. So in the end, it really doesn't matter. Especially because stuff doesn't generally have health that high. Okay, good. I was about to say, that guy like didn't die. And I was concerned. Because fighting both of those guys at once is not fun. I don't know how I'm gonna deal with the Titanite demons. Not the first two, but like two over there. I don't know how I'm going to deal with them. Because Dark Beat only works to a certain extent. I can try Dark Beat though. I mean, who knows? Dark Beat will probably work, so. These guys can be taken care of with arrows really easily. Or these first two can anyway. I'm glad so much of this stuff is really safe to kill, actually. Like, surprisingly safe to kill. Then at this point, you could just. I guess you can't lock on, but you can just slow walk off and plunge. Now that Titanite Demon is definitely bow with Hawk Ring and RTSR. This one over here is probably just Darkbeard, a business as usual. Feel like 90% of the time it's just gonna be Darkbeard. Like not even like magic in general, just Darkbeard. Oh, that was close. Yeah, like especially like Inner Anor Londo is probably Darkbeard. Maybe the gargoyle on the outside, like before you turn the rotunda. Maybe I can take care of him from the bridge with Crystal Soul Spear or something like that. But again, the first gargoyle is definitely Darkbeard. Because you can Darkbeard him pretty safely once you fall down somewhere. This guy, Darkbeard. Yep, everything's Darkbeard. Like, just the entire game is Darkbeard. Yeah, I'm almost definitely gonna just be mindlessly spewing Darkbeard everywhere. Which will be very satisfying, actually. So, I mean, I'm not really complaining. I get to finally use Darkbeard. I've never used Darkbeard before, so I'm a little bit excited. See, I'm definitely killing Logan in his cage. So yeah, here I can either kick Siegmire off or I can. Oh wow, you are just coming after me. He just came after me, holy shit. That was pretty funny though. That guy might be a problem. Actually, he probably won't. Before the first ball rolls through, I can probably hit him with a Darkbeard. And if he doesn't die from that, then the ball will definitely finish him. Yep, the whole world is goddamn Darkbeard. Hey, Siegmire. I mean, I can do this whole bit, or like the whole game in like any order I want though. That's the good thing about New Game Plus, you already have all the things you need. So I could get Izalith out of the way first if I wanted to, with the dragon butts. Actually, DLC might have to go first. Because there's like a lot of shit that can just gank you in DLC. Like there's just a lot of enemies in DLC, so. And Serpent Greatsword. Great sword. Yeah, I feel like I should just stop talking about it though, because we all know it's just gonna be Darkbeard. Okay, don't fall. Thank God. That was kind of close. I didn't expect to not hit that plunge. Okay, that was kind of risky. Actually, can I break this wall with the catch pole? I don't think so. Yeah, it seems like I can't, so. Ever. Oh, actually, I'm pretty sure the Drake sword can do it. Let me just pick out, or let me just grab the +0 one. A tiny AoE, or a tiny shockwave. I guess the Drake sword can't do it. I thought it could. You've let me drown, or you've let me down, Drake Sword. Oh yeah, this switches directions. Actually, wait, I'm being stupid right now. I gotta move that so then it shoots one down there. And then move it back. Okay, now Logan's free. Okay, now I just gotta finish the inner part of the fortress and then we'll be moving on. The outer fortress really isn't that big. Yeah, I turned around again. I don't know why that thing just turns around so much. Two more. I'm gonna do something stupid here. I-framed loser. Oh, back steps for the win. I actually didn't take very much damage from that. Quite surprising. Okay, almost done with Inner Sands. Then I can finally move on. This place is just such a drag. Like it's so boring. It's pretty tedious and kind of backtracky. Really annoying. I don't like Suns, it's just really boring. Oh wow, you're still alive. A parried loser. Okay, I almost just ran off the walkway for no reason. That was almost really stupid. Why did I backstep? Gonna kill the ball drop in. Not casually, but in the all enemies killed, yeah. I don't bother with him because it's just too annoying. Because, like, if you jump over there, you still have the chance of just like falling in the hole where the balls go. So there's no guarantee you'll even kill him if you get over there. Are you ready to parry? Let's parry. Get parried, noob. Wow, what a terrible player. You're getting parried so easily. You suck. Okay, actually, in All Enemies Killed, I really, really, really just want a Dark Bead, Rickard straight in his face. Like, I hate this asshole so much. Fuck you. What a little bitch. Rapiers are for pussies. Okay. Fucking, I hate this enemy. This stupid parrying face. I don't get parried by him because I parry him. Because I know better than to attack this asshole. Like, with enemies that can just straight up parry you out of nowhere, I know better than just straight up attack. I hate it so much though. Like, the skeletons when they go into parry stance, that's so annoying. Okay. Let's finish up Sens. Finally. I'm gonna buy some arrows from this guy, even though they're like more expensive than usual. I don't ever need anything else from him. I don't know why I check. That count as a hit? Would getting caught by that shockwave count as a hit? I don't think it would. Or actually it might. Knowing Team Hitless, I feel like it probably is actually. That kinda sucks. Are you gonna fight me one on one? Oh, you're dead. I cannot remember the last time I got a flamberge from one of those guys. Like, they're one of the only sources of flamberges in this game. And they like never drop it, so I had to buy all 10 that I have from Shiva. Get memed on, loser. I feel like I should use Quelaag's Fury Sword for at least part of the kill all enemies thing. Because that can just like crank out crazy DPS. I feel like I would only really use it on like the bushes in. What's it called? Darkroot. Or on the Crystal Golems because it's pretty good against the Crystal Golems. I don't know. I need to like stop thinking about it right now. Like it's not gonna happen for like I'm not even gonna route it until like tomorrow at the very, very earliest. Like if I complete all of this today, I'm gonna route this tomorrow at the earliest. Or like, otherwise probably starting on Christmas. This guy deserves a dark bead right up the butt. Get casually walked away from. Oh, a 69 in there, nice. Ow, that's loud. Last God, what have you made me do? You made me turn up my volume slightly, and now my ears are just crippled. Look how little damage I'm doing, holy shit. Wow, Iron Golem is really magic resistant. That is not much damage. That's not good damage. Come on. You know you want to stagger. I know you know that you want to stagger. We all know you want to stagger. Not a secret. See? You finally embraced your want to stagger. And I have enough for a level. Let's go. One level. Are you ready for one single level? Let's go. 10 out of 10. That's okay, wait. That's 100% everything block. I know this is not 100% magic block shield. Like for the player. Make it 100% magic block against this. That's kind of bullshit. I'm gonna be honest, that's kind of bullshit. Kinda, yeah. No, like 100% block shields on NPCs are complete shit. Especially when there are like several things that have 100% block shields in one place. It's not fun. Like, even the buckler in the hands of an enemy is like overpowered. It's like they can block everything. Like, they never get shield broken. And it's just terrible. It's the worst. Let's get our level. We're almost at the good number. The best number. Yeah, so the plan for this guy would be Darkbeed. Oh, come on, give me your tail. Not that big of a deal. Did you just. Okay. What the hell hit me? Now give me your tail. It's not that big of a deal. Thank you. I feel like my eye is bruised. I just woke up and it like hurt to touch. It like hurts to touch around like the bottom of my eye. This happens sometimes. Like it's not the first time this has happened, but it sucks. Because it always feels like it's like bruised. Maybe I'm getting punched in the face in my sleep. That'd be interesting if that was happening. Missing parries. I suck. Trash tier player misses every parry. Trash tier player sprints through this place for no reason. This is called rafters. Yeah, sprints through the rafters for no reason, other than being reckless for fun. No item? Okay. Get parried, loser. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get a spell or a dark beat off fast enough there. So I might have to use something and like hit him through the wall. I feel like Soul Spear or Crystal Soul Spear is what I'm gonna use for like half of these guys. Yeah, with something that could like one-shot like that through the wall, that'd be good. Maybe Black Knight Halberd could. Or actually, like, probably any Halberd could on RTSR, as long as it's max upgrade. I have to remember, I'm probably going to be using RTSR. Yeah, and then for this guy, I don't know if Crystal Soul Spear reaches there, but if not, I can just use a Great Bow or something. And if all else fails, I'll get him to do that and drop attack him. And then hope that I get his tail. Okay, I got literally everything from him. That was unexpected. Okay, so this Halberd, the Titanite Catchable is still doing pretty well. I mean, I would honestly expect it to be performing a lot worse than it is currently. Aw, that was a really early roll. That felt like it was traveling way slower than it should have been. Done. Thought so. Oof. That guy. That asshole. He is not fun. I like how you can get both of them just completely suicide though. That's fun. Yeah, so in there I'd use, like with the spear guy in the room over, definitely gonna use, Crystal Soul Spear with RTSR and all that. Is fuck parrying in a hitless. Oh shit. Well, we've reached the limit for this weapon. It can't one-shot parry, so it's trash. Silver Knight Spear. Or shield. It can't one-shot parry, so it's garbage. That's the rule. I mean, it can stagger in two hits, though. That's not bad. Almost time for ONS. Am I ready? No, not at all. I'm gonna try to kill Super Ornstein this time. Or Mega Ornstein instead of Super Smo. That's gonna be fun. Not. And like the only attacks I'm gonna be able to get on Mega Ornstein are roll attacks, which do less damage than normal attacks. So, yay, fun! Ha ha ha! Oh man, that's not gonna be fun. Pain of a long Mega Ornstein is not. It's not fun. O and S, more like dough and stress. That's actually pretty good. That's actually pretty good. I just call him, asshole and fat ass. Because I hate them so much, I can't even be bothered to think of, like, a good pun or anything. I mean, because asshole and fat ass describes them pretty well. No, Smough is. I feel like Smough is worse than Ornstein half the time in this fight. Just because he does like a million shovels when you're 3 feet away. God, I can't wait to just run through here with Dark Bead. Just destroy everyone. Fuck all these guys. That wasn't close enough. Maybe I can't hit this one through the wall. Or, oh, okay, sure, just hit me through the wall. I'm the only one who's allowed to hit through walls here. Oh well, shit. I don't know how to parry that attack. Oh, and that was a shield bash. That's fun. Yeah, but I'm the only one who's allowed to hit through walls here, bud. Okay? You're not allowed to do that. Oh, another Silver Knight shield. Okay. Got it. I'm the only one who's allowed to cheat here. Do these guys have like exactly 1,000 health? Don't worry, Onion Bro, I will save you. Only for you to be killed by your daughter later. Stop. Whatever. These Silver Knights are being really annoying. Okay, some Demon Titanite. I always forget that Demon Titanite is right there. Let's see, that's. So, without killing any Titanite demons, you're gonna have four Demon Titanite at this point. Parried. Ow. Okay, I am in like a lot of physical pain right now. Like, I had a really long day yesterday, and now I'm just sore everywhere. It's very fun. It's so fun just to be like sitting still and then just suddenly be in pain. Wouldn't you agree, Mr. Silver Knight? I mean, you just had a pole just driven through your abdomen. I'd assume you're in quite a bit of pain. I mean, I feel like that's a pretty safe assumption. Okay, let's kill Lautrec because he's a bitch. Fog. And okay, who am I gonna kill first? Oh, so this is a good chance to practice, sneaking around these guys. Or, like, to see, how I can sneak around these guys. Because, like, if I give him a wide berth, he'll give his dialogue. I wish I could move this in this sequence. Okay. So I can't backstab either of them without alerting Lautrec. So I'd say come up behind Lautrec, actually backstab him instead of whatever the hell I just did. But then just run away. I don't know if they're like de-aggroing or just having trouble holding aggro. Oh, I missed him. That was a plunge attack I tried to get him with. So he can probably one-shot me at this point. I feel like this mage has no idea where to aim. Fuck off. Look, I'm trying to kill your friends here. I mean, it's pretty clear I don't need to, but wow, he's on like one health. Ow, dick. See, I don't know if I should include those two in, killing everyone. Okay, and I'm just gonna leave Anastasia's soul right there. Because I don't need another one. I'll just let her stay dead this time. I will grant her peace. Actually, I think she wants to come back alive, but I don't really know. I haven't, like, listened to NPC dialogue enough to care. Oh my god, I'm supposed to be in offline mode, Steam. It's off Steam. I don't want to know what my friends are doing. Wow. 10 out of 10 aim. 10 out of 10. You can totally hit me here. I feel like a RTSR Great Bow to the face would kill that guy. I'm not sure. Honestly, I'm probably not gonna go that way, so I won't need to know. Or at least, like, when I kill that guy, I'll probably be, like, right over here. And I'll just be able to shoot him like that, so it'll be fine. I should have hit you. Thank you. Oh, and S time. Let's go. Do this bullshit. Oh my god, this fight sucks. It's a bad fight. No, don't talk to that guy. Pick up the stupid hawk ring. Repair everything. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with Lautrec and his invasion. Because I can't reasonably Darkbeat the other two. Well, actually, I'll need to test if I can Darkbeat Lautrec, then Darkbeat the other two, while the thing is, like, waiting to transport me back. Because if I can, that'll make things a lot easier. It would probably go Lautrec, Spear Guy, Magic Guy. Because the Spear Guy is the bigger problem, the Magic Guy, he can just attack way faster. Okay, let's make a save state here, because I haven't made a save state in a while, and I don't want to, like, lose all this progress. Let's do this, Ornstein and Smo. Let's do this. Oh, the damage is not bad, actually, and I forgot I'm doing Super Ornstein, or Mega Ornstein. Oh, the damage still isn't bad. Okay, come on, Smo. I was literally in your ball sack, and then you just decide to do a charge. Dude. Both of you just, like, stop. I don't like getting almost fucking two-shot. Actually, literally getting two-shot. Okay, really, Ornstein? Stop glitching around, you little shit. Ow. What a combo. Dude, this fight is, like, so good. This fight fucking pisses me off. Because it's so bullshit all the time. Like, what is Ornstein doing right now? Okay, I don't know where the fuck that came from, Ornstein. Oh my god, your stupid hammer. I hate your hammer. Oh man. Fuck. I don't know how to dodge that with Mega Ornstein. Look at that amazing glitch charge. God, and the hitbox on that attack is so terrible. God, screw this fight. I don't know why the hell I'm doing Mega Ornstein. I mean, because I need to, but... Look! Look at that bullshit! It's the shittiest hitbox on an attack ever. Okay, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna go to the restroom. And then we're gonna come back and kick this fucker in the dick. I'm back. And we're gonna go again with ONS. This time, not get shitty hitboxes with Super Ornstein or Mega Ornstein. It's not true at all. I'm 100% gonna get shit hitboxes. Okay, Smough's Hammer almost just drugged me back into Ornstein's hitboxes. Oh wow, what a miss. Dude. I hate fucking charge when it's that close. Same with that charge, Ornstein. I mean, it's not as bad, but it's still pretty bad. Just fuck off. Oh, great. Ornstein's whole body is like a hitbox on that attack. Not fun. Oh, he didn't follow it up, thank God. Fuck off, Ornstein. Oh my God, let me hit you. Dude, fuck this attack. You just gotta, like, pray for good RNG. Super or Mega Ornstein. Honestly. Especially with such a bad weapon against him. I don't know how anyone feels comfortable fighting this asshole on a hit list. Unless he starts spamming this attack. That's completely fucking understandable. What a joke. Okay, like, the three attacks he's been doing most recently are the ones that are good. Okay, so you have to dodge this, like, slightly before. What? Wow. Wow. Okay. Fucking... no. Okay, I'm not gonna bother with Mega Ornstein on this weapon. Fuck that. Damage is too bad. Also, after ONS, I'm probably gonna be done. Pretty tired right now. I had a very, very long day yesterday. And I just sort of wanna lurk in other people's streams and chill. Ornstein, where did you backstep to? You were supposed to backstep. Stagger. Okay, Smough, that was the longest fucking charge in existence. What? Fuck off. And then you do a short one when I'm really far away. And it makes total sense. Now, I like you a lot better when you glitch around like this, Ornstein. But, like, glitch in a good way. fucker. He just starts a charge for no goddamn reason. Oh, I'm dead. Look at that. Look at that bullshit. He just started a charge for no fucking reason. And then, okay, wow, this is a shit fight. This is a shitty fight. He shouldn't have started a charge there. He really shouldn't have started a charge there. Now I gotta do it again. My god. This fucking fight. So much goddamn fun. It's the worst fucking fight in existence. Especially that goddamn instant backstep away from everything Ornstein does. I am so far in a corner, I can see Smo's asshole. It's not really much of a challenge, but still, it's not something I want to see. Okay, what fuck was that? Well, I'm dead. I am as good as dead. I can't see shit. And I'm in a fucking corner. God, see, this is why this fight is just shit. Just because shit like that's too easy to happen. Okay, and again, what the fuck are these short charges? These, short shovels. Smo, I'm gonna fucking kill your mom. I'm gonna find your mom and fucking stuff her own hair down her throat after fucking scalping her. I'm gonna fucking scalp your mother and choke her to death with her own fucking hair. That's how much I hate you. Just because I hate you so much. Honestly, fuck this asshole. And again, another short fucking shovel. Great fight. And at least he was behind a pillar this time. Wow. What a plink. I'm gonna kill someone. Someone's dying today. Somebody is... Smo, fuck off. Somebody is fucking dying today. That's all there is to it. And it's gonna be both of you. And then instantly with the fuck you. No, fuck you. You're not allowed to do that. I'm allowed to attack you before the cutscene starts. You're not allowed to attack me while the cutscene ends. Okay, where was the stagger? One of those should have been a stagger. God fucking asshole. And stagger. Oh. My fucking god. I'm dead. I hate this fight so much. You can't do anything. Fuck you. Terrible fight. Okay. That is more than enough of that. Okay, so... that's gonna be the end of this stream. While I'm offline, or while I'm not streaming, I'm gonna sell extra shit to Frampt, and I'm gonna upgrade all the weapons and armor to plus 5 or plus 3, depending on if it's a weapon or armor. And, yeah. And that's how you get Lautrec set. Yeah, I'm gonna do that, and then... so I might have more or less souls than now, probably a lot less. And I might have to like dip into my boss souls just to have enough souls to finish it, or like farm souls. I don't know, so we're just gonna see. And if I have to farm souls, then whatever. I doubt I'll have to farm souls though. So yeah, that's gonna be the end of this stream. So, thank you for watching, and hope you have a great time.